Good morning, children. Welcome back in your English class, and I hope that you all are fit and fine, feeling happy and healthy. Children, as you know that we have started Daring Diet narration from grammar portion, and we have completed up to imperative sentences. So children, we have in last lecture we have completed imperative sentences, and I have explained you the imperative sentences, how to change the imperative sentences from direct narration to indirect narration, and I have explained this topic through examples and through notes, and I have explained all the sentences, all the types of sentences, whether it is assertive sentences, integrative sentences, imperative sentences, and their rules to change from indirect to direct narration through notes and the examples. So children, we have completed and up to the imperative sentences along with the explanation and along with the examples. So in today's lecture we are going to start the last section of the grammar, direct narration, that is the exclamatory sentences and optative sentences. So children, we are going to start today in today's lecture the explanation of the exclamatory sentences and the optative sentences, and we are going to study about their rules to how to change the how we can change the exclamatory sentences from direct to indirect narration, and also we are going to study about the optative sentences, how we can change the optative sentences from direct to indirect narration. So children, in today's lecture we are going to start two types of sentences, that are exclamatory sentences and second one is optative sentences. In today's lecture we are going to study that how we can change the exclamatory sentences from direct to indirect narration, and also along with the exclamatory sentences we are also going to study about the optative sentences, and we are going to study about their rules, how to change them from direct to indirect narration. And definitely, of course, as usual, I will show you, I will explain these two topics, these two sentences and their rules, how to change from direct to indirect narration through examples and through notes. So children, let's start doing explanation of these two sentences, exclamatory sentences and optative sentences. And children, I request you, kindly take your pen and copy with yourself while watching the video, because you have to write all the rules of the sentences, how to change the rules to change the sentences from direct to indirect narration in your grammar copy, and write down some examples also along with the rules. So children, please take your copy and pen with yourself while watching the video, and I hope that you got the point. So let's start the explanation of these two topics. Good morning, children. As you know that we have started direct and indirect narration from grammar portion, and we have completed up to imperative sentences. We have already completed how to change the imperative sentences into indirect narration. We have completed, and I have also given you the one solved exercise and one unsolved exercise for practice at home, and I hope that you got it, and I have sent you through PDF, and please write down all the sentences solved as well as the unsolved sentences in your grammar copy. So children, in today's lecture we are going to start the next type of sentences, that is the exclamatory sentences. And exclamatory sentences, before starting the rules of indirect narration, how we can change the exclamatory sentences into indirect narration, first let's know about the definition of exclamatory sentences. What is exclamatory sentence? So children, this is another type of sentence, and we have already completed the imperative sentences. Now let's start doing, let's start study, let's start discussion of exclamatory sentences. Now see the definition of this type of sentence. What is an exclamatory sentence? Sentences containing surprise or emotion are called exclamation or exclamatory sentences. Now sentences containing surprise or emotion are called an exclamation or exclamatory sentences. An exclamation or exclamatory sentences. An exclamation point is placed at the end of the such sentences. You have seen the exclamation mark like this. This is an exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. This is an. Okay, children. Now let's see the examples. How beautiful this star city is. This is an exclamation sentence with an exclamation mark at the end of the sentence. Now Sarah wiped the board. See the mark. Please help me now. This is another sentence of this type. What a coincidence this is. This sentence also has an exclamation mark at the end of the sentence. Now let's start the how to change the exclamatory sentences into indirect speech. Now these are the exclamatory sentences, and now we are going to study how to change exclamatory sentences into indirect speech. Now let's see the examples. First we will study, we will know about the rules. Now the rule first, interjections. You know what are interjections? Interjections like words like hooray, hooray is for joy, alas for sorrow, and what how for surprise, and bravo for approval. These are the interjections. Now interjections like hooray, hooray for joy, alas for sorrow, what a and how for surprise, and bravo for approval are removed. First of all, the first rule is all the interjections words are removed while changing the exclamatory sentences into indirect speech. This is rule first. Now rule second is reporting verb. Now reporting verb said to or said should be changed into exclaimed, and how? According to the sense of reported speech. Yani reported speech mein jaisa exclamation sense hoga, jaisa aapka usme sense hoga, emotion hoga, uske accordingly jo hai aap reporting verb ko change karenge. Yani said to ko ya said ko usko change karenge. Agar joy hai, agar hurray diya hua hai reported speech mein, to iska matlab hai ki wo joy ke liye hai, to exclaimed with joy. Aur agar aapka usme diya hua alas diya हुआ इंटरजेक्शन रिपोर्टेड स्पीच में, तो अलास इज फॉर ग्रीफ एंड सोरो, तो उसके लिए हमें एक्सक्लेम्ड विद सोरो और ग्रीफ करेंगे. तो अकॉर्डिंग टू द सेंस ऑफ द रिपोर्टेड स्पीच, अकॉर्डिंग टू द एक्सक्लेम्ड इन द रिपोर्टेड स्पीच, वी विल चेंज द रिपोर्टिंग वर्ब सेट टू और सेट. नाउ रूल थर्ड, इन्वर्टेड कॉमास कन्वर्ट इन टू दैट. इन्वर्टेड कॉमास विल कन्वर्ट इन टू दैट. And the fourth one is full stop is used in the place of exclamation mark. Full stop is used instead of note of exclamation. This mark ki jagah pe hum full stop karenge. It means you can say that ki exclamatory sentence will convert into assertive sentence. Full stop agar hum laga denge to exclamatory sentence will become an assertive sentence. Now rule 5, when what or how is followed by an adjective. Agar what or how ke baad adjective aapka sentence mein diya hua hai, then we will use very. To hum usko very se connect karenge. But when what is followed by a noun, lekin agar what जो है उसके बाद नाउन लगा हुआ है, देन वी विल पुट ग्रेट. नाउ सी द एग्जाम्पल. example of rule 5. Example of rule 5. See, Ram said to me, how fast you are walking. Now, how is here? And how is followed by what? Fast. Fast is an adjective. Fast adjective है और ये now ये जो है आपका how के बाद लगा हुआ है. तो अगर how is followed by an adjective, then what you will do? Ram exclaimed that, exclamation mark को हटाएंगे और exclaim लिखेंगे and यहाँ पे said, यहाँ पे आपका said is in the past form, so we will put exclaim. We will put the reporting verb in the indirect narration also in past tense. So Ram exclaimed that I was, yani you is for me. So I was walking very fast. Ya how hai? To how ki jagah pe kya aap lagayenge? Very. Agar how ke baad an adjective hai, basically kya hota hai ki how is generally how jo hai is followed by an adjective, non by, not by any noun. तो यहाँ पे हाउ जो है वो आपका एडजेक्टिव है. हाउ के बाद एडजेक्टिव लगा है तो आप वेरी लगाएंगे और एडजेक्टिव एज इट इज रखेंगे. नाउ सी दैट अनदर एग्जांपल. ही सेड दैट व्हाट अ फूल आई एम. नाउ हियर व्हाट इज गिवन एंड हियर नाउन इज गिवन. ही सेड व्हाट अ फूल आई एम. नाउ यहाँ पे आपका है, आप यहाँ पे आपका नाउन दिया हुआ है, व्हाट के बाद नाउन दिया हुआ है. देन हाउ यू विल चेंज. ही एक्सक्लेम दैट ही वॉज अ ग्रेट फूल. यानी आप जो है वो what को convert करके आप क्या लिखेंगे, what you will write, great. He exclaimed that he was a great fool. Now see the formula. I'm now see the all these कैसे आप उसको change करेंगे, how you will change the exclamatory sentence into indirect narration. Now see, subject plus exclaimed plus that plus other subject. From a reported speech say we will take the subject plus verb by changing the tense. जैसे कि अगर past tense है यहाँ पर, जैसे कि यहाँ पे past tense है, so according to the reporting verb, according to the tense form of the reporting verb, we will change the tense form of the reported speech. So by changing the tense plus very plus adjective, यानी adjective अगर होगा तो very लगेगा, और अगर great कब लगेगा, when there will be a noun. When there will be an adjective with how, then we will put very. And when there will be a noun when there will be a noun after what, then we will put great. Now see, now let's see the example of all the rules one by one. Now if happiness is shown in reported speech, agar reported speech mein happiness show ho raha hai, then reporting verb will be converted into how? Exclaim with joy or exclaim with delight. अगर reported speech में happiness expression या उसके emotions आ रहे हैं, happiness के कुछ emotions या expression show हो रहा है, then the reporting verb will be converted into exclaim with joy. Then we will write the reporting verb like exclaim with joy or exclaim with delight. How? See the examples. He said, "Hooray! My old friend has come." Now hooray is for joy. Hooray is an interjection, and this interjection shows what? Happiness. The state of happiness. Yani ye happiness ka state show kar raha hai, bhav show kar raha hai, feeling show kar raha hai, situation show kar raha hai. Then how you, and according to the first rule, interjections are removed, should be removed. Aur interjections ko hum hata dete hain while changing into indirect narration of the exclamatory sentences, and according to the expression of the reported speech, we will change the reporting verb. Now how? He exclaimed with, hooray is for delight, hooray is for happiness. So he exclaimed with delight that his old friend had come. Had yahan pe kyun ho jayega? Because here the verb is in the past tense. Here the verb is in the past tense. So in the reported speech also the verb should be in the past form. Not agar do verb ek saath hai, agar helping verb hai aur main verb hai, to aap jo verb pehle aayega wo aap usko convert karenge past tense pe. To yahan pe kam bhi main verb hai aur helping verb has hai, but has jo hai wo pehle aaya hua, so we will change the has into had. So here he exclaimed with delight that his old friend had come.
Now see, you can write this sentence like this also. He exclaimed joyfully. अगर आप joyfully लगा रहे हैं, then with आप नहीं लगाएंगे. He exclaimed with joyfully नहीं होगा. और you can write like this. He exclaimed with joy, not with joyfully. If you write joyfully, then you don't have to write with. You don't write with. So he exclaimed joyfully or with joy that his old friend had come. Now see there, another example. Gaurav exclaimed with delight. Now see the sentence. Gaurav said, "Hooray, we have won the match." Now hooray is for happiness, hooray is for joy, hooray is for delight. Then how you will write, how you will change the into indirect narration. Gaurav exclaimed with delight or joy or joyfully. Agar joyfully hai, to you will not put with. To aap with nahi likhenge, only you have to write joyfully. Gaurav exclaimed with delight or joy that they, we is here. So we will change into pronoun they. So that they had won the match. They have ka kya ho jayega? Had, because here the verb is in the past form. So that they had won the match, or you can write like this. Gaurav exclaimed joyfully that they had won the match. How you can write this sentence into three forms, into three ways. The first way is Gaurav exclaimed with delight that they had won the match. Second way is Gaurav exclaimed with joy that they had won the match. Third one is Gaurav exclaimed joyfully that they had won the match. In three ways you can write this sentence, this type of sentence. Now see the another sentence. She said, "Wow, what a pleasant weather it is." It is, wow is for delight, wow is for happiness, wow is for joy. So how you write? She exclaimed with joy or delight or joyfully. Joyfully ke saath hum with nahi lagayenge. So she exclaimed with joy that it was. Now pleasant weather, it is here, and is will change into was because the verb is in the past form. So she exclaimed with joy that, remove the inverted comma and put that here, it was a very, because what is here, and followed by a noun, and followed by a noun. Agar noun hai what ke baad, to aap yahan pe very lagayenge. No, sorry, not noun, but what is followed by an adjective. Yahan what kisse follow kar raha hai? Adjective. Pleasant is an adjective. Weather kaisa hai? Pleasant hai. To ye adjective show kar raha hai. Yani what is followed by an adjective. What is followed by an adjective. Aur agar adjective है तो हम यहां पर what की जगह पे very लगाएंगे. अगर what, how, अगर एक adjective के बाद adjective, अगर what या how के बाद आता है, then we will remove what and we will write very in indirect narration. So how you write? In three ways you can write. She exclaimed with joy that it was a very pleasant weather. She exclaimed with delight that it was a very pleasant weather. And she exclaimed joyfully that it was a very pleasant weather. Now see the another rule. If sorrow is expressed in reported speech, जैसे कि उसमें happiness था, तो आप happiness, hooray, wow, इस तरह के जो interjections जब use हुए, तो उससे show हो रहा था कि state जो है, वो आपका happiness का है, खुशी का है, happiness का है, joy का है, delightful का, delight का है. तो what you have done, you will write like exclaimed with joy, exclaimed with delight, exclaimed with, या exclaimed joyfully. Agar, now if the second one is that, if sorrow is expressed in reported speech, if reported speech shows an interjection of sorrow, agar reported speech mein sorrow agar wahan pe expression show kar raha hai, then reporting verb will be expressed as, ya will be written as, exclaimed with sorrow or grief. Now see the examples. He said, "Alas, I am ruined." Now, alas is an interjection and it expresses the emotion state of ग्रीफ, ये दुख की सिचुएशन जो है वो एक्सप्रेस कर रहा, शो कर रहा है. सो हाउ यू राइट, ही एक्सक्लेम विद सोरो और ग्रीफ दैट ही वॉज रूम. सोरो या ग्रीफ में दोनों में से कोई एक लिख सकते हैं. यू कैन राइट ओनली वन, वेदर सोरो और ग्रीफ. यू कैन राइट लाइक दिस, He exclaimed with sorrow that he was ruined. I is for he is for I. तो यहाँ पे I he हो जाएगा. I is for he. तो यहाँ पे he हो जाएगा. And am should be in the past tense because here the reporting verb is in the past tense. So he exclaimed with sorrow that he was ruined. He exclaimed with grief that he was ruined. Now see another example. Another rule. If applause or praise express in reported speech, अगर reported speech में applause या praise के interjections हैं और वो applause or praise show कर रहे हैं, then reporting verb will be as praised or applauded. See the example of this rule. He said to us, "Bravo, you have done well." Now, how he said to us, "Bravo." You have done well. Now, bravo is an interjection. और ये interjection है. This interjection shows an expression of praise, applaud. तो how you write? He applauded or praised. Whether you write applauded or praised. And applauded is in the past form or praised is in the past form because here the reporting verb is in the past form. So you should write applauded, praised. You should write the verb in the past form in indirect narration also. Now he applauded or praised us. Now us is here, said to is will be converted into applauded or praised. Us saying, what are you saying? Saying that, remove the inverted comma, that we, us is for we is for us. So we had done well. He applauded or praised us saying that we had done well. Now see that another example rule. If good heavens is in the reported speech, agar good heavens reported speech mein likha hua ya diya hua hai, then the reporting verb will be as exclaimed with regret or surprise. Good heavens interjection hai wo kya show kar raha hai? Regret or surprise. Now see the example. Good heavens, I have dropped my key somewhere, he said. He exclaimed with regret or surprise that he had dropped his key somewhere. He exclaimed with regret or surprise that he had dropped his keys somewhere. So children, this is your this is an exclamatory sentence. These are the rules how you can change the exclamatory sentences into indirect narration. And I have shown you the rules with the example. So let's move on. Now next type of sentence. This is the last sentence type of sentence that you can say that the optative sentences. So this is another type of sentence called optative sentences. And before starting the making the these sentences into indirect narration, let's know what is an optative sentence. Now the sentence which expresses a prayer, keen wish, curse, etc. is called an optative sentence. यानी वो sentence जो कि prayer या wish, desire या curse show करता हो, expression दे रहा हो, is called an optative sentence. This kind of sentence generally starts with may and wish. So this kind of sentence generally starts with may and wish, and sometimes may remains hidden. I repeat, the sentence which expresses a prayer, keen wish or desire, curse, etc. is called an optative sentence. This kind of sentence generally starts with may and wish. Sometime may remains hidden. Now let's see the examples. May the king live long, and exclamation mark होता है, कभी होता है कभी नहीं होता है. So the may the king live long. And may the Almighty help in this tragedy. Now may he is here, wish is here. So these are the exclamatory sentences. Wish you a very happy journey. Wish you a very successful married life. May your team win the match. All these are the optative sentences. Not exclamatory sentences. These are the optative sentences with the exclamation mark. Sometimes the sentences have exclamation mark, and sometimes the sentences have, some sentences have not. Now note, optative sentences indicate a wish, prayer, or desire occurs. It ends with exclamation mark. Sometimes it does not end, but sometimes it ends with exclamation mark. That is, it is like this. Now see the rule, how to change optative sentences into indirect narration. अब हम लोग पढ़ेंगे कि कैसे हम indirect narration में optative sentences को change करते हैं. What are the rules? How we can change? Now rule first is to making indirect speech of optative sentences. Reporting verb, that is said to. Reporting verb में said to जो दिया रहेगा in reporting verb is change. According to the optative word or mood of the reported speech. जैसा कि आपका exclamatory sentences में था कि reported verb में जैसा आपका expression होगा interjection के through, वैसे ही आप reporting verb को change करेंगे. अगर हुर्रे है तो happiness से show कर रहे हैं तो delight से show, exclaimed with delight है, exclaimed with joy. अगर alas है तो exclaimed with sorrow और grief है. Bravo है तो exclaimed, applauded और praised है. In the same way, in the optative sentences also, agar set to will change according to the optative word or mood of the reported speech. Aur kis tarike ka jo is tarah ke words hain, wo kaise hote hain? Optative, what are those optative words which are changed according to the mood or according to the optative words given in the reported speech? वो कौन से रिपोर्टेड जो व्हाट आर द ऑप्टेटिव वर्ड्स गिवन इन द रिपोर्टेड स्पीच एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दोज ऑप्टेटिव वर्ड्स द रिपोर्टिंग वर्ब सेट टू विल चेंज. यानी कौन कौन से ऑप्टेटिव वैसे वर्ड्स हैं जो रिपोर्टेड स्पीच में दिए होते हैं जिनके अकॉर्डिंगली रिपोर्टिंग स्पीच सेट टू को हम चेंज करते हैं इन इनडायरेक्ट नरेशन. So let's see the list of those optative words which are in the reported speech and from which we can change the reporting verb set according to those optative words in the reported speech. Let's see those words. Now see, these are the optative words in the reported speech, and these are the, and when we change the optative sentences into indirect narration, we will put in the place of said these words according to these optative words. Now see, good morning wished, good evening wished, good afternoon wished, good night ke liye bade, goodbye ke liye bade, farewell ke liye bade, for would that wished, oh that wished, oh for wished, may or may god prayed, if where only imagination. तो इसके लिए wished या would, यानी काश ऐसा होता, these type of sentences के लिए हम wished और would का use करते हैं. So these are the optative words which are in the report, which when we have these optative words in reported speech, then we will change by changing these optative words into these words instead of said. So let's see the examples. Now see the examples. Good morning के लिए अगर reported speech में good morning है तो वो wish हो कर रहा है, wished होगा. जैसे he said good morning mom, he wished his mom good morning. Now see, Ravi said good morning my friend, Ravi wished his friend good morning. अगर good morning है तो वो wish कर रहा है. Now good evening, अगर good evening reported speech में तो उसके लिए भी wished है. Sachin said good evening uncle, Sachin wished his uncle good evening. गुड नाइट के लिए बेड भी यूज कर सकते हैं, यू कैन पुट एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज विश्ड. प्रशांत सेड गुड नाइट पापा, प्रशांत बेड हिज पापा गुड नाइट. प्रशांत सेड गुड नाइट पापा, प्रशांत बेड हिज पापा गुड नाइट. नाउ सी अनदर, goodbye agar if there is goodbye in the reported speech, then for goodbye bade is used. See the example. Aman said goodbye friends. Aman bade his friends goodbye. Aman said goodbye friends. For goodbye bade is used. Aman bade his friends goodbye. And would in reported speech, agar if there is would in reported speech, then you will put what? Wished. Set to ko kya change karenge hum? Wished mein. Agar yahan pe goodbye hai, to hum set ko kis mein change karenge? Bade mein. So see the example. Set to would change into wished if there is would in the reported speech. Neha said to him, would that you were here at that time. Now, Neha wished that he had been. Agar would hai, ye would is for imagination. Ye imagination pe hai ki kaash aisa hota. So if there is an imagination shown by would, to aap isko past perfect mein change karenge. Past perfect continuous ka jo rule hoga usme change karenge, yani aap yahan pe been lagayenge. Past perfect continuous. To yahan pe kya laga denge? Past perfect yani had been. To Neha wished that he had been there at that time. Now see another examples. Oh that, agar reported speech hai, oh that hai. Oh, if there is oh that expression in reported speech, then said to will change into wished. He said, oh that I had the wings of bird. He wished that he had the wings of bird. He is for he, I is for he. So yahan pe pronoun he use hoga, had the wings of bird. If may is in the reported speech, then may is for wish. And may is for desire, may is for curse, may is for prayer. May jo hai aapka, wo kaun sa expression show karta hai? That may expresses is used for desire, prayer or curse. So they now see. He said to me, may you live long. Here the blessing, here the wish is giving. So he wish is shown. So he wished that I might live long. You is for me is for you. So you ki jagah pe I ho jayega pronoun. So I wish that I might live long. Now see another example. The hermit said, may you all go to hell. The hermit is giving a curse. Now here the curse expression is showing. So how you change, how you will write. The hermit cursed that they all might go to hell. May you, now the hermit said, may you all, you all means plural form. May you all is in the plural form. So they is used in indirect narration. So the hermit cursed that they all might go to hell. Now for wishes ke liye, curse ke liye wished, wishes ke liye hum, we will use wished, and curse ke liye we will put cursed in the place of said, in the place of said. So I repeat once again children. Good morning in reported speech wished. He said good morning mom. He wished his mom good morning. Now he said another example. Good morning my friend. Ravi wished his friend good morning. Yeah, agar good morning hai, then the said will convert into wished. The said will convert into wished. Agar aapka now good evening, if there is good evening in reported speech, then said will convert into wished. Now Sachin said good evening uncle. Said will convert into wish. Sachin wished his uncle good morning. Now good night in reported speech. If good night is in the reported speech, then the said to is said will be converted into bade or wished. Prashant said good night papa. Prashant bade his papa good night. Yeah, or you can write that Prashant wished his papa good night. Now goodbye in reported speech. Then if there is goodbye in reported speech, then bade. Then said will convert into bade. Said will change into bade. Aman said goodbye friends. Aman bade his friends goodbye. Now would in reported speech. Agar if there is would in reported speech, then wished is here. And you will change in, and you will put, but you will change the reported speech into past perfect continuous. Lightly like this. Not a verb mein ing nahi lagega because it is for imagination. Ye imagination pe based hai. Neha said to him, "Would that you were here at last time." Neha wished that he had been there at that time. Now another, if there is "oh that" in reported speech, then said will change into wished. He said, "Oh that I had the wings of bird." He wished that he had the wings of bird. Now may is for desire. May is used for desire. May is used for prayer. May is used for curse. So it is according to the reported speech what you put. Now main reported speech. He said to me, "May you live long." Here wish is here. Expression wish ka hai. To yahan pe jayega, he wished that I might live long. The hermit said, "May you all go to hell." Now this sentence, the reported speech shows an expression of curse. So here "you all" is in plural form. Then the hermit cursed that they because you all means plural form. The hermit cursed that they all might go to hell. Now children, these are the optative sentences, and these are the rules of optative sentences, how you change the optative sentences into indirect narration. So these are the rules how to change the optative sentences into indirect narration. So we have done in today's lecture exclamatory sentences and optative sentences we have done. So with these explanation, with these two sentences, we have also completed our direct and indirect narration. So children, we have completed the with these sentences we have completed direct and indirect narration in today's lecture. So in next lecture we will start next topic. So and take your pen and copy with yourself and write down all the rules in your fair copy along with the examples. So children, take care of yourself and your family. Goodbye.